we're asked to factor the given two trinomials. We'll be factoring these two trinomials using the shortcut method for factoring trinomials in the form x squared plus bx plus c. Looking at the trinomials though, we may be thinking these trinomials don't fit this form, but remember, the first step in any factoring problem is to factor out the greatest common factor. Looking at the first trinomial, notice 2 is the greatest common factor among these three terms, so we'll begin by factoring out 2 from the trinomial. So we'd have 2 times, we factor out 2 from 2x squared, we're left with x squared, plus we factor out 2 from 28x, we're left with 14x, plus we factor out 2 from 96, we're left with 48. Now notice the trinomial inside the parentheses does fit the form of x squared plus bx plus c, because now the leading coefficient inside the parentheses is equal to 1. So if this does factor further, we'll factor into 2 and then 2 binomial factors. And now to use the shortcut method to factor the trinomial inside the parentheses, we look for two integers, which we'll call r and s, whose product is equal to c, the constant term, and whose sum is equal to b, the coefficient of x. Once we find the value of r and s, the factored form will be the quantity x plus r times the quantity x plus s. So notice how inside the parentheses, c is equal to 48 and b is equal to positive 14. So we're looking for two integers, which we'll call r and s, whose product is 48 and whose sum is equal to 14. So because the sum is positive, we should be able to recognize the two integers that give us a product of 48 will both be positive. Let's go ahead and list all the positive integers that have a product of 48. So 1 times 48, 2 times 24, 3 times 16, 4 times 12, as well as 6 times 8. And again, we're looking for the integers that also have a sum of 14, which means we're looking for the integers 6 and 8. Again, because 6 times 8 equals 48, and 6 plus 8 equals 14. So let's let r equal 6 and s equal 8, which tells us the two binomial factors of x squared plus 14x plus 48 are x plus 6 and x plus 8. This is the factored form of the given trinomial. And now let's look at the second example. The first step is to factor out the greatest common factor. Notice all three terms contain one factor of y, so y is the greatest common factor, but because we want the leading coefficient of the degree 2 trinomial to be positive, let's factor out negative y rather than positive y. So we'll begin by factoring out negative y. If we factor out negative y from negative y cubed, we're left with positive y squared. We factor out negative y from positive 17y squared, we're left with negative 17y. If we factor out negative y from negative 30y, we're left with positive 30, so we have plus 30. Notice if we distribute, we do get negative y cubed plus 17y squared minus 30y. And once again, notice how the trinomial inside the parentheses does fit the form of x squared plus bx plus c. So if this does factor further, it'll factor into negative y times 2 binomial factors. Now looking at the trinomial inside the parentheses, notice c is equal to positive 30 and b is equal to negative 17. So we're looking for two integers that have a product of positive 30 and that have a sum of negative 17. So because the integers must have a sum of negative 17, and the product must be positive, we know we're looking for two negative integers that have a product of positive 30. So we could have negative 1 times negative 30, negative 2 times negative 15, or negative 3 times negative 5. The integers we're looking for are negative 2 and negative 15, because negative 2 times negative 15 is equal to positive 30, and negative 2 plus negative 15 equals negative 17. So we'll let r equal negative 2 and s equal negative 15. Which means the two binomial factors of y squared minus 17y plus 30 are y plus negative 2, or just y minus 2, and y plus negative 15, or y minus 15. This is the factored form of the given trinomial. I hope you found this helpful.